Today, we'll be taking a look at an entry-level ITX AMD B650 motherboard by Gigabyte, the B650I AX. Positioned as more of a no-frills ITX offering that serves up support for AMD's current Ryzen 7000 and 8000 series of processors, as well as the upcoming Ryzen 9000 series that should be launched sometime towards the end of 2024 or early 2025. Let's see if this board is any good. Now, the UD series, short form for Ultra Durable, refers to products in Gigabyte Stable that are targeted more at value-conscious end users, where it places below the Gaming X series of products targeted at gamers on a budget and below the Aura series of enthusiast class offerings. In view of this, the box comes in the usual greyish-black colorway that has an Ultra Durable motif splashed across the front in a bronze color, and moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual summary of specs for this board. We'll cover these specs in depth later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALKtech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. Now let's set aside the board for now to see what accessories Gigabyte has included with the B650i AX. Given that this is more of a no-frills motherboard offering, we get a regulatory information leaflet, an I/O shield, two SATA 3 cables, a pair of Wi-Fi antennae, as well as a M.2 drive mounting screw. And here we have it, the Gigabyte B650i AX. As you can see, it sports a black PCB with grey motifs on its heatsinks to add some visual interest to the board. As more of an entry-level motherboard offering, the B650i AX does not come with any integrated RGB LEDs, though it does of course come with RGB headers. I'll talk about the placement of these headers later on in this video. You'll notice that Gigabyte's gone for a traditional I/O layout without an integrated I/O shield, and we get a low-profile heatsink that cools the 5+2+1 power delivery solution that the board comes with. Now, given its VRM setup, this board would be well suited for low to mid-range Ryzen 7000 or 8000 processors with a lower TDP. A low-profile passive heatsink is used to cool the AMD B650 chipset, and possibly as a cost-saving measure, the lone M.2 drive slot that this board comes with does not come with a heatsink. In terms of memory support, the B650i AX comes with two DDR5 slots with support for up to 96GB of RAM and the DDR5 6400 standard when overclocked, with plastic slots of a single tabbed design that would definitely help with the installation and removal of memory modules in the confines of tight ITX cases. Moving on to front panel USB connectivity, we get a USB 2.0 front panel header that provides support for up to two front panel USB 2.0 Type-A ports, a USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header that supports up to two front panel USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, and to round things off, we do also get a USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-C front panel header. In the expansion slot department, the B650i AX comes with a single PCIe 4.0 x16 slot for a graphics card, where the SID slot comes with the PCIe Easy Latch feature. PCIe Easy Latch is essentially an oversized graphics card retention tab, which allows you to remove a graphics card from the motherboard in a completed PC build with ease. For storage devices, Gigabyte has included two SATA 3 ports, and in terms of M.2 slots, the B650i AX comes with a single PCIe 4.0 x4 M.2 slot. Do note that this slot supports NVMe SSDs only. SATA M.2 drives are not supported. For audio, Gigabyte's included an entry-level Realtek ALC 897 audio codec, while wired internet connectivity is courtesy of another Realtek part, the RTL8125BG, that serves up support for 2.5 gigabit Ethernet. Wireless connectivity is courtesy of a Realtek RTL8852CE Wi-Fi 6E module that also comes with Bluetooth 5.3 as standard. In the cooling and RGB departments, the B650i AX comes with three fan headers that are located in these regions of the board. Also included is a single addressable RGB header and a single 12-volt standard RGB header located in these regions of the board. In terms of rear I/O, Gigabyte included a DisplayPort 1.4 port that supports display output of up to 4K resolution at 144Hz, a HDMI 2.1 port that supports display output of up to 4K resolution at 60Hz. We do also get two USB 2.0 Type-A ports, two USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, of which this port here supports the Qflash Plus feature, a Qflash Plus button that allows you to update the board's BIOS without needing to install a CPU, RAM, or graphics card, a 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet port, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A port, a USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-C port, Wi-Fi antenna connectors, as well as your usual audio jack connectors. In conclusion, the Gigabyte B650i AX shapes up to be a balanced budget motherboard offering that will be well suuited for entry-level AMD AM5 PC builds in the ITX form factor, with features such as 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, Wi-Fi 6E, as well as quality of life features such as PCIe Easy Latch. As of May 2024, the B650i AX can be had for a price of around SGD 285 through offline and online retailers. For you international viewers, this converts to roughly $209. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.